Hello everyone and a very good afternoon. We are back with another episode of Entrepreneur India Smart Investing Series, your weekly dose of personal finance that can help you make better decisions with your money. I am Shupra Singh, Chief Correspondent at Entrepreneur India and your moderator for today's panel. So today's episode is about SEBI's recent move on multi-cap funds, under which these funds are now mandated to invest 25% each in large cap, mid caps and small cap stocks. So we've gathered today to discuss how does this move impact investors who are invested in the multi-caps category. So let me start by laying out the ground rules for our attendees. We request everybody to please attend the webinar from a quiet room with headphones and sit in an area with maximum internet signal so that to avoid any kind of lag during the webinar. We encourage participation, so please keep your questions ready. Drop them in the Q&A box present at the bottom of your screen. For those of you who are attending through Facebook, please drop your questions in the comment section in Facebook Live. And at the end of the discussion, we'll take up all the questions and get them answered by our experts present with us today. So to introduce you all to our speakers, we have with us today Radhika Gupta. She's the CEO of Edelweiss Asset Management. Radhika has in the past also built her own venture for Front Capital Management, which was an alternative asset management firm, which was later acquired by Edelweiss in 2014. In her tenure with Edelweiss, she has successfully led the company's acquisition of JP Morgan's mutual fund business and Ambit Capital's AIF business in 2016. Radhika is also a board member of AMFI. Welcome, Radhika, and thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
Our second speaker is G. Pradeep Kumar. He's the CEO of Union AMC. Mr. Pradeep Kumar is a BTech PGDM from IIM Ahmedabad and a veteran in the mutual fund industry. During his professional career of more than 25 years, he has worked with IDFC Investment Advisors as the Chief Marketing Officer, UTI Asset Management Company as Senior Vice President, and UTI International Limited as Director and CEO. Welcome, Pradeep. Thank you very much for taking out the time to join us today here.
Thank you, Shubha.
So first up, you know, so I want to start with, so it's been a while since the move came out. And, you know, initially we also, I mean, the initial reactions were that there will be a lot of outflow from the large cap category and a lot of inflows in small cap and mid cap. But now that it's been a while and, you know, the AMCs have gotten some time to comprehend the move completely. So now I want to understand, you know, how do you see that, you know, the new rule impacts multi-cap funds and the stock market in general? So let's start with you, Radhika.
I think, you know, what happens unfortunately or fortunately when circulars like these come out is, and while they're very important circulars, we move into very quick analysis mode. In fact, on this circular, I think it came out on Friday, and by Friday evening, there were comments on the future of small caps, what's going to go wrong in the large cap universe. By Monday, people had put research reports out on this without understanding that, look, this is a nuanced issue. The multi-cap category is a 1 lakh crore category. It's not a joke. And ultimately, asset management companies, advisors, will do what is in investors' interest. And that is a thoughtful decision. So just because a circular has come out and mandates 20, 30,000 crores of buying in small cap funds, which some funds may be too large to do, doesn't mean people will irresponsibly go ahead and do that. People will take time to evaluate their options. And I think that is what is happening. And people will have sensible dialogues with regulatory authorities. So I think right now what people are doing is having a dialogue with SEBI as to what you've seen. AMFI has written a letter to SEBI also on this front as to what the potential options in the multi-cap space are. Now, if you look at from an investor point of view, I would agree that when an investor invested into multi-cap funds, they came in with a mandate that was similar to the BSE 500 benchmark, which is about 20% mid and small cap and the balance 80% large cap, and which is what most multi-cap funds are mirroring. The new proposed multi-cap category by SEBI is a far more aggressive fund because it is 50% mid and small cap. So I think one, funds will have to decide what they are going to do. Either a fund in the multi-cap category says, okay, I'm going to change my constitution to meet this, or I'm going to swap to another category. Basis that, I think investors will have to take a very thought through decision fund by fund, multi-cap fund by multi-cap fund, as to what they want to do. Are they comfortable with a great category? And by the way, some investors will say, you know, I'm comfortable. In which case they should stick. And if they are not comfortable with that, is their fund migrating? Should they migrate? So I just think it has to be a lot more thought through decision. And I think you receive that communication from fund houses within the next few weeks. But certainly a weekend or a week is not a time to take a decision.
Would you like to add here, Pradeep?
Yes, I 100% agree with what Radhika said, that you know, people have a tendency to jump to conclusions. You know, you have you know, it's very easy to put an Excel sheet and say that, okay, 1,46,000 crores is a multi-cap AUM. Out of that, you know, 36,000 crores need to move into mid-cap and small-cap to have the rebalancing. So 24,000 crores for mid-cap or small-cap, 12,000 crores for mid-cap. This is a market cap, this much money will go, and suddenly everything will shoot up. I mean, it's all fine. You know, if all you have to do is run an Excel sheet, you know, it's a fine calculation. But market doesn't move on Excel sheet basis. And that is why over that weekend itself, SEBI came up with a further clarification, saying that, you know, increasing the allocation to mid cap and small cap is one of the options available to AMCs. There are other options available. Okay. So it is not necessary that, you know, every fund will go and buy mid cap and small cap stocks just to rebalance. In fact, I think all fund houses, all leading fund houses have made it amply clear that they are not going to buy mid cap and small cap at exorbitant prices just to comply with the circular. So there are other options which include, you know, merging multi cap fund with, you know, other funds, for example, you know, a large and mid-cap fund, etc. So, you know, we as mutual funds, we are examining various alternatives available to us. We have also been engaging with SEBI at industry level. AMFI is very actively engaged with SEBI to make sure that, you know, there is no disruption in the market and the interest of investors is not, you know, not affected. Because ultimately, what SEBI is interested in and what we are interested in, it's all the same thing. We want to do what is the best thing for the investors. So, you know, I think a solution will emerge. There are so many possibilities. And, you know, you also would have seen reports in the media talking about another possibility, which is, you know, a new category being created, like a flexi-cap fund. So, you know, if something like that happens, you know, it's all like a storm in a teacup, you know, nothing will happen to the market. So it's something, you know, on which we need to wait and see what is the response, what are the decisions that the mutual funds individually and at industry level, what emerges before, you know, jumping into any conclusion. And I would like to just add that I too am an investor and, you know, probably the largest exposure I have in my portfolio is towards multi-cap funds. And I have not touched my portfolio after the circular. As an investor, I'm waiting because if I invested with 10 and 20 year horizon, I'm not going to, you know, undertake any knee-jerk response just because of the circular. I trust the mutual funds, you know, with whom I have placed the money.
All right. So as you rightly said, you know, there will be multiple options with the AMCs and with time we'll get to know, you know, any individual AMCs will be taking individual steps. But if we have to, like, you know, one by one, look at the possible options. So, for instance, for those funds who do readjust their allocation to different caps. So, I mean, so far, you know, the multi-cap funds, since, I mean, the category average has been 70% in large cap funds, which is essentially what has been driving the, you know, returns. So in that sense, when the after the reallocation, should investors you know, brace for higher volatility and extended period of poor returns after a particular fund kind of increases their exposure to small and mid caps?
I think, look, if you are going to be a fund with 50% mid and small cap, that is a very different risk grade than 20% small cap. I think you just have to realize that. There is one argument, and this is just my personal opinion on the proposed new multi-cap category. See, you need some funds that exist that are a little flexible from a fund management point of view, where there's really scope to do alpha generation. I think if I had asked my CIO, he always, and I had always asked him, you know, what is your favorite fund category? And he used to say multi-cap because it gave me the flexibility to play across the cap range depending on market conditions. So multi-cap was a very flexible category where the fund manager could really play across the range. I think if you had to come to the proposed category, the flexibility does go away. One third is also something I can do individually by combining my own large cap, mid cap and small cap fund. I don't need someone. So it's like a quasi passive fund in my view with a slightly higher risk rate. So that's my take on the new category.
What about you, Pradeep?
So, yeah, I entirely agree again. And I would like to just add that if any investor in a multi-cap fund eventually find that the fund in which, you know, he is invested is simply going to, convert it into the new SEBI circular and increase the exposure to mid-cap and small-cap, that is going to be a different product from the one which he had signed up for. Okay, because you signed up thinking that the fund manager has complete freedom. The fund manager will exercise her judgment about, you know, which multi-cap, which market cap is more suitable or more attractive. And if that freedom is taken away and there is a more straitjacketed approach, that may not be the fund that the investor signed up for, in which case the investor will need to take a call whether this is something, you know, that meets their, risk appetite, this meets their investment goals. And most of the investors, you know, would also have good advisors to help them. And together, they will need to sit down and take a call on that. But as of now, my view is that there will be very few instances of AMCs simply, complying with the new circular by increasing the exposure to mid-cap and small-cap. And I would also like to add that, you know, that seems to be, that realization seems to be sinking in the market also, which is why after that initial jump in mid cap and small cap last Monday, things seem to have settled down.
So actually we have the point that you were just making, we have a query on Facebook from one of our viewers who's asking, will there be a further rally in small cap stocks in the coming months triggered by, you know, MF houses buying in small and mid cap categories?
My take on this, and I had tweeted something around this, is that, you know, if you invest, and I think Pradeep said this about his own investment in multi-cap, if you are investing in small-cap funds or mid-cap funds, I assume you're doing it with a 7 to 10 year horizon, otherwise you should not be making that investment in the first place. If you're doing it because there's going to be a 3, 4, 5, 7% rally in mid and small caps over a 7 year horizon, one, that's not going to make a difference. I think if you want to invest in mid and small caps, you should invest for the right reason. And that right reason, in my opinion, can never be a circular, because one, you don't know whether this rally will happen, as Pradeep said, because of a circular. Just because an Excel sheet says you have to buy this much small cap doesn't mean people will go ahead and buy it. Secondly, you know, mid and small cap is a very specific category. It requires a certain risk-taking appetite and ability to digest volatility and a certain time horizon. And you should buy mid and small cap funds. And I actually think you should buy mid and small cap funds as a part of your asset allocation, but not because of the circular, because they have underperformed large caps for a significant period. And at some point there will be a reversion in that. So I'm saying buy the asset class for the right reasons, not for a circular, because in 7 years, I can tell you the circular will not matter.
So in that sense, you know, exactly. From diversification. Yeah, please go ahead.
Sorry. Yeah. So you know, again, just to supplement what Radhika said, see, we always advise investors and even the distributors that every investor should have some allocation to small cap and mid cap. And we typically compare it with, you know, spice in the food. You need certain quantity of spice, you need certain quantity of salt, but you can't say that, you know, spice will form the core of your meal, right? That's not healthy. You should have everything in the right quantity. So if somebody, you know, a prudent thing, for example, would be to take a call that, yes, I would like to have 10% allocation to small cap stocks in my portfolio, maybe 15% allocation to mid cap stocks. Okay. So, you know, to have a straight jacketed approach is probably not, going to help most investors unless they have higher risk appetite. you know, it's up to individual investor, and if they take that call, it's perfectly fine. But again, you know, to go and buy small cap or mid cap, thinking that, you know, there will be an artificial rally in those stocks is going to be, you know, very naive in my view, and not going to really help investors, because, you know, the market is very smart. I think people who think that they are smarter than the market typically end up paying a heavy price. So we must respect the market. We must respect the fund management industry and regulator. So there will be a more nuanced solution that will emerge, and each AMC, like we said earlier, will take a call, you know, keeping in mind the interest of their investors. So jumping into small and mid cap just because you think there'll be a short term rally will be, you know, very disastrous, can be very disastrous.
Okay, so from diversification point of view, do you think that this move will actually help investors to kind of diversify, you know, those who didn't have exposure to, separately exposure to smaller mid caps, but now they will be after this?
I think small and mid-cap exposure is something that an asset allocation should determine for an investor. I don't think diversification should be forced on an investor. For instance, I'm a reasonably conservative investor, so most of my investments are actually in balanced kind of funds. I'm a reasonably conservative investor. I don't hold large small cap. To force a certain amount of mid and small cap down my throat because of diversification, I don't think that's right. I think mid and small cap allocation should be a function of the asset allocation and the risk-taking appetite, because we've seen enough times after small cap rallies, investors come in at the wrong times chasing returns, and then they have a terrible experience. It's very hard to digest the volatility, especially in small caps. There are single-day small caps which are down 20-30% in a day. In fact, you know, I mean, you'll get comments from investors, a small cap stock will be down 20% a day, and you'll immediately start getting questions from investors. So you should never force diversification of this kind of risk grade. Things like small cap, mid cap, credit risk, these are satellite allocations for people, and I don't think they should ever be forced down people's throat.
Absolutely. And it's also not, you know, correct that people are hugely underexposed to small cap. If you just look at the AUM numbers, you know, large cap as a category has about 1,48,000 crores AUM at the end of August, while small cap as a category has 52,000 crores. And, you know, the mid cap category has 88,000 crores. So, you know, mid cap is more than half of the large cap AUM, the mid cap funds. And small cap funds are, you know, about one third the size of the large cap AUM. So these are, you know, quite meaningful exposures in my view, given the representation of small cap and mid cap in the market as a whole. If you take, you know, the Nifty 500 or the BSE 500, etc., in which, you know, the share of small caps is probably in single digits, you know, to have this kind of exposure to small cap and mid cap funds is quite meaningful. So investors in general have been taking meaningful exposure to small and mid cap fund, small and mid cap stocks, through, you know, focused funds, I mean, dedicated funds in those areas. So again, you know, forcing something on multi-cap, you know, may not be what they had really, you know, signed up for.
Okay, so we have, I mean, this is not really a question, but a view from one of our viewers, Rajendra Joshi, who's saying that the current category should be reclassified as FlexiCap, a new multi-cap category as per SEBI notice should be created. So in the interest of investors, the default should be to continue in the existing category. However, in their own decision, they can switch to the new category. So what do you have to say about this? I mean, this gentleman is suggesting that we reclassify it as a FlexiCap category instead.
Honestly, I think that's the right thing to do, because FlexiCap, I mean, you call it multi-cap, you call it FlexiCap, you need one category where equity fund man, I mean, if active fund management has to exist, you need one category where active fund managers can take asset allocation calls across the market cap curve and pick good companies, good or, I mean, whether big, small, whatever. And you need one category. Whether that category is multi-cap or flexi-cap, it's all nomenclature. So I think you definitely need a flexi-cap category. If I were to hazard a guess, if flexi-cap came up, for instance, we would be very interested in changing our multi-cap fund to a flexi-cap fund if that were an option, because we just think it's a better risk profile product than the current multi-cap fund. proposed multi-cap.
Absolutely, because you know that's something that can address all the concerns. You know, the concern of the regulator that funds should be true to label, concern of the AMCs about being consistent with what was the value proposition to the investor. Because you know, we also need to look at when we sold multi-cap funds, even today when we are selling multi-cap funds, what exactly are we telling the investors? We have been telling them that this is a fund in which the fund manager has a flexibility. The fund manager will decide what is the best thing to do at any given point of time and decide the allocation. So that is a value proposition that we have been offering to investors. So I think there should be a category which allows the mutual fund industry to continue to offer that value proposition. You call it FlexiCap or you call it XYZ, whatever. It would be very good to have such a category in which the flexibility is maintained.
All right.
So I hope
all right. So to talk about the other two categories you have of a fund or merging it with another fund. So in either case, what is it that the investor should know? How does either of the two move impacts the existing investors in multi-cap funds?
Chitra, I missed your last question. I couldn't hear it very clearly.
Am I audible now?
Yeah.
I think there is a bandwidth issue at your end.
Shubhra, I can't hear you.
Maybe you can switch off your video for a few moments.
Yeah. I think she's logged off and I'm assuming she'll log back on.
Yeah, we'll just wait for a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for the interruption. My internet was kind of playing up. Am I clear now?
Yes, loud and clear.
Okay. So as I was asking, to talk about the other two options that AMCs have of either reclassifying the fund or merging it with another fund. So in either of the cases, what is it that the investor should know if either of the two happens with their existing multi-cap fund? How does it, what changes for the investor?
So I think if you're merging, it depends on what fund you're merging into. For instance, large and mid, in my view, is a pretty similar category to the existing multi-cap fund. So that may not be such a bad thing. Just one thing to keep in mind is that, as funds get bigger in size, they also get significantly less nimble in their ability to do things. So a merger of two very large funds creates another very large fund. So that's just something to keep in mind. And then it clearly becomes a large and mid fund. If they're flipping categories, I think we already talked about FlexiCap. There are a few other thematic categories like ESG, etc., that have been proposed. I think then you really need to evaluate category by category. Ideally, what investors should think is, what did I sign up for when I bought this fund? Where did it fit in my asset allocation? And after the change, what is the fund going to look like? And does it reasonably match that? If it doesn't reasonably match, then I need to do a rethink. If it does, then I'm reasonably okay. So you don't want turnover for the sake of turnover also.
Yeah, very, very, very true. It's very important because all AMCs are probably not going to take the same action. So there could be AMCs, depending on the current construct of their portfolio. There will be those who decide that, it's better to merge it with a large and mid-cap fund, like Radhika suggested. And, there could be another AMC which thinks that it's better to merge it with a large-cap fund. Okay, so there are different possibilities and individual cases, the investor will need to take a call looking at their overall portfolio. How exposed they will be to small cap stocks as a result of that particular merger, and how exposed they will be to mid cap stocks as a result of that action. And then, decide if they are overexposed, then, there will be some reallocation that will be warranted. But if it stays within their overall risk appetite, then it's fine. But it's very important to realize that there is no uniform solution or a uniform approach to this in case, you know, merger of schemes is what the AMC ends up doing. So each individual investor will need to take a call depending on their overall portfolio exposure to mid cap, small cap, and large cap stocks.
Okay, so one of our viewers, Sasana Puri Ravi Kumar, I would like to hand him over the mic. He has a lot to, I think, share and discuss with our speakers. Ravi, please switch on your audio. Sasana Puri Ravi Kumar, please switch on your audio if you want to ask our experts a question. Shalini, please give him the mic. Yeah. Yes, we can hear you. Please ask your question.
Hello.
Yes, Ravi, we can hear you.
The question is, it should be according to the mandate given by SEBI only, because what happens when the investors or distributors go for a higher YTM, it will automatically lead to higher risk. We have not expected a black swan event like COVID, but it happened. So always stick to what the mandate as per SEBI means a multi cap should not be like a large cap. Multi cap should have all exposures. Even large caps also have higher risk. Even some banks in the large cap have failed. Even some big PSUs and Navratnas, which were large caps, also failed. So it should not be like a particular market cap. It should be like a multi-cap means multi-cap. That's all.
Radhika, can I respond to this?
Please.
Yeah. So absolutely, we entirely agree with you in the sense that funds should be true to label. Okay. So whatever SEBI stipulates, all mutual funds will follow that. It's not something on which, you know, we have an option not to follow. So if SEBI says in multi-cap funds, you know, 25% should be mid-cap, 25% should be small-cap, all mutual funds will follow that. Okay.
Yeah.
So if SEBI comes up with a different, guideline in future, or they create another category, so then we will consider that at that stage. But not following SEBI circular is not an option. No mutual fund will do that.
I would only say that I have been, and I think we've been some of the biggest advocates of true to label, both in equity and fixed income schemes. Schemes should do what they are meant to do, and they should follow the guidelines, even beyond regulatory guidelines. I think even when regulatory guidelines are unclear, we've tried to be more true to label. So I think it is an absolutely necessary thing. And the question of violating what SEBI says, obviously, as Pradeep said, does not exist. But I think giving the consumer what he signs up for is the core of our business, because ultimately we are in a business of trust. So I don't think that's a question.
All right. Thank you, Ravi. Thank you very much. Shalini, please hand over the mic to Neerath. He also has a question.
Yes, Neerad, please ask your question. जैसे बैलेंस एडवांटेज फंड में होता है कि ऑटोमेटिकली इक्विटी टू डेट स्विचिंग होता है, वैसे मल्टी कैप में, लार्ज मिड स्मॉल कैप में ऑटोमेटिक स्विचिंग वाला कोई मॉडल किसी एमसी के पास है कि क्या है, या ऐसा हो सकता है?
I can take that. आई थिंक यस, बैलेंस्ड एडवांटेज फंड में आप स्विच कर सकते थे बिटवीन इक्विटी एंड डेट. इनफैक्ट बैफ नाउ आफ्टर द सेबी कैटेगराइजेशन मेरे हिसाब से सबसे ज्यादा फ्लेक्सिबल कैटेगरी है फंड मैनेजर के लिए. आई थिंक अर्स्टवाइल मल्टी कैप फंड जब हम चलाते थे विदाउट प्री द सेबी गाइडलाइंस, यू वर स्विचिंग बिटवीन मल्टी लार्ज एंड मिड कैप. अब मॉडल के बेसिस पे करते थे या फंड मैनेजर डिस्क्रेशन के बेसिस पे करते थे, आई थिंक दैट इज ईच इंडिविजुअल्स कॉल. जस्ट लाइक बैफ में भी some people will do it basis model, some people will do it basis discretion. किसी का ऐसा मॉडल होगा, किसी का वैसा मॉडल होगा. इन द न्यू सेबी कैटेगराइजेशन ऑफ मल्टी कैप आप ये स्विचिंग नहीं कर पाएंगे, क्योंकि 25-25-25 का आपका मैंडेट हो चुका है. इन अ प्रपोज्ड फ्लेक्सी कैप आप कर पाएंगे, बट आप ठीक कह रहे हैं दैट इन अ बैफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट देयर वाज अ वेरी नाइस थिंग वेयर यू कुड स्विच बिटवीन इक्विटी ऑन डेट. वो फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी पहले टाइम में मल्टी कैप में रहती थी.
और you know automatically large mid small as a to the best of my knowledge you know no AMC is really following such a model abhi aajkal shayad kuch quant funds hai to usme aise hone ki chances hai but it's not a very very popular strategy right now kyunki fund managers hamesha stocks ke upar dhyan dete hain जो स्टॉक अच्छे हैं, जिसमें ग्रोथ पोटेंशियल है, प्राइस रीजनेबल है, वो स्टॉक लेते हैं और मार्केट कैप के ऊपर यू नो उतना फोकस नहीं देते हैं इन अ मल्टी कैप फंड.
I hope Neeraj's question got answered. So before I take any more questions from Zoom, I have one more question on Facebook. Vansh is asking that I am already invested in small cap stocks. So does it make sense to stick with my multi cap investment anymore? This, of course, I mean this applies when you know the his fund actually chooses to kind of reallocate this thing.
I think Pradeep said this first. Think about how much small cap allocation you currently have. Are you comfortable with it? And say you had, you know, 10% small cap allocation. After the multi cap change, you're going to have 20% small cap allocation, hypothetically. Now you need to decide, am I comfortable with that 20%? There are two ways to get rid of that 20%. Either you cut down your existing small cap fund or you come out of your multi cap fund. So do this math that how much do I have today? What am I comfortable with? And then how much will I have in the future? Ab mujhe rebalancing karni hai. Rebalancing karne ke do tarike.
All right. Okay. So next up is Dutt Sharma. Shalini, please hand him the mic. Dutt Sharma.
Hello, Radhika. This is for you specifically.
Yes.
Dutt, you're not clearly audible. Can you please speak a little loudly?
Okay. I said this is specifically for Radhika because each fund house has a huge category of funds and. Catering to a bouquet of products that they have brought out from time to time as and when the need has arisen. Now, suddenly out of the blues, when SEBI says that you go in for 25, 25, 25, after donkey's number of years of the bouquet being served, and the next day on a Sunday, to say that you can change over or merge to another or have a flexi-cap fund, was there a need to do this at all is my question.
Okay, so this is a tricky question, Datsab, and I don't know why you specifically addressed it to me, but you have, I will have to answer it. So, and Pradeep can add his view on this. See, I am, you know, not the regulator, and I think a lot of thinking happens. I think as a head of management company, I can speak, and I can only say that a few things. One is that I don't believe that we should have. I've actually been an advocate of less categories of funds. I just think between so many equity categories and some 20 fixed income categories, we have too many categories of funds. My father still does not understand the difference between all the short-term debt categories. He's like, mujhe batao savings account wala kaun sa fund hai. So I generally think we have an industry need to simplify. So I don't believe in a large number of funds, a large number of NFOs. I'm generally very against this kind of stuff. That said, you operate within the guidelines of regulations because you are a regulated industry. What we would want to do is, again, in the maximum investors' interest, if we can retain multi-cap in the way that people bought multi-cap, because, for instance, we build our multi-cap fund up from 20 crores to the 500 crores or odd in the last 2-3 years. We want to retain it in the way that investors came into it, and we will do whatever to retain it in that form, whether I have to put a flexi cap into it or whether I have to merge it into a large and mid cap. But I don't want to change the color of the fund to upset people who have already come in. The first interest will always be to serve existing customers. And ideally, I would like to do this without proliferation of too many funds. So that is my take on it. I unfortunately can't give a very philosophical answer as to what was right or wrong, because I'm a participant of an ecosystem that has to follow existing regulations.
Yeah, I think, SEBI had its own reasons, which they explained, why they did this. Every individual has a right to, agree, disagree, which is fine. But as responsible participants in the industry, we have to follow what the regulator wants us to. And we will. It's just that, we are trying to figure out a way in which this can be achieved without being very disruptive. And while, holding our promise that we originally made to our existing investors. Like Radhika said, there is a certain value proposition that we made to our investors in multi-cap fund, saying that, this is how we will run the fund. And if you all of a sudden change that, yeah, there is a problem as far as the existing investors are concerned, and we'll need to address that. Which, again, going back to what we said in the beginning, is something that, we are all working on, and we'll come up with a solution which, protects the interest of investors.
Okay, so I'll take up one last question from Facebook. Even though this is not directly related to the topic today, but I'll still take it up. Debagge is asking, my investment in DSP small cap fund is still in the red, though investments in large and multi-cap funds have largely recovered. Should I exit the small cap fund?
So I would not want to comment on a fund specific thing, especially when it doesn't concern our own fund. I would only say that while large caps have seen a significant rally, there has been an underperformance in the mid and small cap category relative to large caps. So small caps as a category have trailed a little bit. Again, I don't want to comment on the performance of an individual fund because that would not be fair to me. I think when I evaluate a fund, I have some principles. Obviously, if I'm investing in a small cap fund, I give it time. And I also look at how the benchmark is done. So if my fund is in line with all small cap funds, has my fund done significantly worse than all of them? Has it done significantly worse than the benchmark? Then I have a reason to be alarmed. But if the small cap category is down over the same period and my fund is also down a little bit, then I don't get as alarmed. So that would be my broad thought.
Absolutely. Can't comment on individual funds, but just to give you what is our view as Union Mutual Fund, how we view the large, mid and small cap categories. According to our analysis and our current view is that all three categories offer similar growth potential for the next 5 to 10 years. Okay. Or, so if you choose your funds, well, and trust the fund managers to choose the right stocks, all these categories will give you more or less the same set of growth in future. So shifting from, one market cap to another may not be, the best thing to do for most people. But individual funds is a different call that, you will need to sit down with your advisor. I would, once again, very strongly recommend that you consult a good distributor or a good advisor and take a call on what needs to be done with the individual fund.
All right. So that brings us to the end of our discussion today. So, just to sum up, I think what I have gathered from the conversation is that right now, investors should wait and watch, see what the individual AMCs do, and accordingly take a decision on their multi-cap funds. I hope that our viewers had some good takeaways from the discussion today. And well, thank you very much again to both Radhika and Pradeep for joining us today. Thank you very much, all our viewers, for joining us today in this very insightful discussion we had. Have a good day, everybody. Please stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you again.
Thank you,
Shipra, and thank you, Radhika.
Thanks, Pradeep.
Good to see you. Bye-bye.